Now let's talk about the mathematical expression of reaction rate, how to calculate reaction rate mathematically. Say we are dealing with a chemical reaction where reactant A undergoes some chemical changes and product B is produced. So that the rate of the chemical reaction would be equal to the change in the concentration of A divided by the change in time T, or it can also or similarly calculated by using the concentration of B as the product. So it's the change also in concentration of B divided by the change in time T. Okay, if you are using a compound A as our reactant, we will start with A2, or the concentration, the molar concentration of A at time 2, minus the molar concentration of A at time 1. So that we are dealing with our chemical reaction. We are defining two points, T1 and T2. At T1, there is A, the molar concentration of compound A at T1, and the molar concentration of compound A at T2. So the rate would be the molar concentration of T at T2 and minus the molar concentration of A at T1 divided by the change in T, which is T2 minus T1. This value is what we call the change in the molar concentration of A, and this is what we call the change in time T. لو بصينا على الجدول دوت هنلاقي ان احنا عندنا different time intervals for a chemical reaction between butyl chloride and water. Reaction with water is a hydrolysis reaction. Butyl chloride is in the aqueous solution form, and water, of course, is a liquid. When they react together, they produce butyl alcohol and hydrochloric acid. This table gives us the different time intervals and the corresponding molar concentrations of butyl chloride, the reactant in this reaction. We have two reactants, that's water and butyl chloride. We are using the concentration of butyl chloride as one of the reactants, okay? You can see T is starting from zero, then 50 seconds intervals, then starting with 100 seconds intervals, and then increasing the interval until we reach 10,000 seconds. The unit here is the second, while the concentration of butyl chloride is in molar, and we are given the corresponding molar concentrations of butyl chloride. Being a reactant, you can see that the concentration is reducing by time until we reach it zero molars at 10,000 seconds. We can calculate the average rate of this reaction by using the equation we have been talking about in the previous slides. We take two time intervals, two time values, and we take the corresponding concentrations at these times. We subtract them from each other and subtract time from each other. So we have change in concentration divided by change in time. And as long as we are using butyl chloride, so we can express the rate as the change in the concentration of butyl chloride divided by the change in time. This is the same equation we have been talking about. So to calculate the rate, we are using two time points. We will use this as T1 and this as T2. So this would be X at T1 and this would be X at T2. 2. The change in concentration would be equal to x at T2 minus x at T1, divided by the change in time, which is 50 minus 0, to give the final result of rate. If we calculate the average rate throughout the whole reaction, as you can see, we used every two successive points as T1 and T2, and then used this and this as T1 and T2, and then again this and this as T1 and T2, and we calculated the different average rates throughout the reaction. If you look at the average rate values, you can see that the rate is reducing, and this is logic. The reaction starts with the highest rate because we have the highest concentration of reactant. And then concentration of reactant is decreasing, so that the average rate would be also decreasing. يبقى احنا هنا بنتكلم انه لو حسبنا الريت لكل two points في الرياكشن هنلاقي ان الريت بيبتدي باعلى حاجه خالص لان دي اعلى كونسنتريشن احنا ابتدينا بيها في الرياكتنس. اعلى كونسنتريشن للرياكتنس هي البوينت الستارتنج بوينت بتاعت الرياكشن. بعد شويه بيبتدي الكونسنتريشن بتاع الرياكتنس يقل، فبالتالي بنلاقي ان الريت هو كمان بيبتدي يقل. هنلاقي ان اقل ريت هنوصل له هو اللي موجود في اخر نقطه خالص اللي هي قبل ما نوصل للزيرو مولر كونسنتريشن للبيوتايل كلورايد. طيب احنا لو حبينا نعمل بلوت او كيرف يمثل الريت اوف كيميكال رياكشن هيبقى شكله عامل ازاي؟ what if we want to express the rate of chemical reaction in the form of graph or plot? It will be in the form of a relationship between time in seconds, and that would be on the x-axis, and concentration in molars on the y-axis. And the concentration would be that of products or reactants according to what we would like to express or what's available in our values. Okay, as long as we are dealing here with the concentration of reactants, so we will find the curve declining or decreasing, or the slope is reducing by time through time, because the concentration of reactants is generally decreasing as the reaction goes on. بما ان الرياكشن مستمر فالكونسنتريشن بتاع الرياكتنس هيبتدي عالي ويبتدي يقل تدريجيا واحده بواحده، والشكل الكيرف هيبقى كده. But in case we are dealing with the concentration of products, we would expect the plot or the rate taking this form. It would be increasing and not decreasing, because as we all know, the concentration of products is increasing by time. Here also will be time in seconds, and here will be the molar concentration of products as molarity. Okay, so this is called the rate plot. This is the rate plot. And if we want to calculate the rate from this curve, we can do it at any point from the curve. If we want to determine the rate at this point, we would draw a tangent line using a ruler to draw a tangent line to the curve at this point, and take the two ends of the line and detect them on the curve. This is the first and this is the second, and on the corresponding values on T. So this would be T1, this point, and this would be T2. This would be X at T1 and this would be X at T2. we need to calculate the rate, so we can easily calculate the rate by calculating the slope of this line. The slope would be the difference in y's, the y values here, divided by the difference in the x's. So, measuring the slope of the tangent line to the curve at any point is equal to the instantaneous rate at that time. The rate at this point is called the instantaneous rate. يبقى احنا بنحسب الريت ازاي يا شباب؟ يبقى الريت من الكيرف بيتحسب ازاي؟ بيتحسب بطريقه سهله جدا. هنحدد البوينت اللي احنا عايزين نقيس عندها الريت، وبعدين هنرسم بالمسطره تانجنت، مماس للكيرف عند البوينت ديت. والتانجنت لاين دوت هناخد فيه كده نقطتين، نجيب الاكسس بتاعتهم، يعني البوينت التو بوينتس الكورسبوندنج ليهم على الاكس اكسس، ونجيب التو كورسبوندنج بوينتس على الواي اكسس، ومحتاجين نجيب السلوب بتاع اللاين ده. طيب هو السلوب بيساوي ايه؟ بيساوي التشينج ان واي باي ذا تشينج ان اكس، فرق الوايز ديفايدد باي فرق الاكسس. طيب فرق الوايز احنا هنجيبه من هنا، من ال y axis، وفرق ال axis هنجيبه من هنا من ال x axis. ال slope دوت هو هيساوي ال rate at that point. All reactions slow down over time. دي حاجة ثابتة. This is a constant concept. It's not changing. All reactions decrease in rate or slow down over time because the concentration of reactants decrease also by time. Now we have, so far we have two methods for calculating the rate. Number one, the equation, which says that the rate is equal to the change in molar concentration, whether reactants or products, divided by the change in time. And number two, the curve, the graphical method, by calculating the slope of the tangent line to the curve. Okay, now we have two methods for calculating the rate, and later on we will have a third method, a third equation to calculate the rate. طيب يبقى احنا كده عندنا طريقتين لغاية دلوقتي بنحسب بيهم الريت، يا إما mathematical عن طريق الـ equation، يا إما graphical عن طريق الكيرف زي ما قلنا. والبوينت اللي احنا بنحسب عندها الريت، الريت اللي بنحسبه في الحالة دي ما دام عند certain point كده في وسط الرياكشن بيبقى اسمه instantaneous rate. Instantaneous rate. What about the instantaneous rate at T0? What if you are requested to calculate the rate of the chemical reaction at T0, at the starting point of the reaction, which would be the highest rate? احنا بنتكلم اننا بنحسب الريت عند ال starting point بتاعت الرياكشن اللي هو هيبقى اعلى ريت ممكن نشوفه في الرياكشن دوت. طيب في الحالة دي هنعمل ايه؟ في الحالة دي صعب ان احنا البوينت اهي، صعب ان احنا نمد التانجنت في الناحيتين، ما ينفعش نمد التانجنت بره الكيرف كده. طيب يبقى احنا عندنا التانجنت في اتجاه واحد بس اللي هو هنا هو، تمام؟ يبقى احنا هنحسب من هنا من اللاين من النقطتين دولت، هيبقى النقطة الأولانية اهي والنقطة التانية اهي. طيب هنجيب الكورسبوندنج ليهم على الواي اكسس، ادي بوينت 1 وادي بوينت 2، وبعدين هنجيب الكورسبوندنج ليهم على الاكس اكسس، ادي الاكس 2، والاكس 1 هتبقى هنا اللي هي هتبقى الزيرو، تمام كده؟ ونحسب منها الريت بنفس الطريقة بتاعت السلوب، الـ difference of y's divided by difference of x's، والresultant would be the instantaneous rate at T0، أو بنسميه بقى ليه اسم تاني بما إنه at the starting point، فهيبقى اسمه initial rate. What is initial rate? Initial rate is the instantaneous rate at the beginning or at T0. Okay, so now we have two terms. We have the instantaneous rate that's the rate at any point of the reaction, and we have the initial rate that's the rate at T0 or the rate at the beginning of the reaction. We have a third term that's called the average rate. The average rate. Average reaction rate would be the change of concentration between the beginning and the end of the reaction. It's the rate throughout the whole period of the reaction. The whole period of the reaction. We will start with T1 and T2. T1 would be 0, and T2 would be the end of the reaction. In this case, the rate is called the average rate. And that's different from the instantaneous rate. Instantaneous rate is the change in concentration over only a short period of time. Only a short period of time divided by this short time elapsed. While in case of the average rate, we divide it by the total time elapsed during the reaction. The whole reaction time. Okay? So now we have the initial rate, we have the average rate, and we have the instantaneous rate. You must differentiate between the three. You must differentiate how to calculate any of these rates. The third method to calculate the rate of the chemical reaction is through using or applying the law of mass action. The law of mass action. The law of mass action has been first proposed by two scientists at 1867. Those two scientists are Goldberg and Wage. Goldberg and Wage defined the law of mass action, which states that the rate at which a substance reacts is proportional to its active mass. So, law of mass action related rate to active mass. Let's take an example. If reactant A and reactant B are combining together to produce a product. This reaction is expressed as a balanced equation that n moles of A equal plus m moles of B produce the product. In this case, the law of mass action states that the rate is proportional to the active mass of the reactants. So we have reactant A and reactant B. The active mass of reactant A is the molar concentration of reactant A raised to a power equal to the number of moles appearing in the equation. So the active mass is the molar concentration of A raised to the power n. While the active mass of B would be the molar concentration of B raised to a power of m. This is the active masses of these reactants. So, the rate of chemical reaction is directly proportional to the product of the active masses or the molar concentration of the reactants. So that if we have two reactants like these, so that the rate is proportional to the multiplication of their active masses. If we want to remove the proportionality sign and convert it into an equation, we must add a constant. احنا واخدين طبعا اللي اخد الناس اللي واخدين ماس قبل كده عارفين ان انا لما يبقى عندي proportionality form كده, يعني الريت هنا proportional للاكتف ماس اوف A multiplied by the active mass of B, عشان احول دي لصورة mathematical equation بشيل proportionality sign وحط مكانها constant. الconstant اللي احنا حطناه هنا اسمه small k. Small k is the constant here and would be called the rate constant. Let's take an example. This is the commercial reaction for production of nitrogen gas. Production of nitrogen gas is performed by reacting an aqueous solution of ammonium salt with aqueous solution of nitrite salt to produce nitrogen gas and water. In this table, we have the different reaction mixtures that can be performed for applying this reaction. Different concentrations of ammonium and different concentrations of nitrite and the corresponding initial rates. We will be using initial rate in this case as a judgment. Instead of taking any point during the reaction, we will consider the initial rate being the highest rate during the reaction. The highest rate during reaction. التابل هنا عطيني كذا example لكذا reaction mixture حيتمه ما بين الأمونيوم salt والنيترايت salt عشان يدوني النيتروجين gas. لو الconcentration اللي ابتدينا بيه للأمونيوم كذا والنيترايت كذا, الcorresponding rate حيبقى الvalue دي. تمام؟ طيب, احنا عندنا 8 examples أو 8 experiments أو 8 reaction mixtures والcorresponding concentrations والcorresponding rate of reaction اللي هيحصل مع ال concentrations ديت. والريت اللي احنا هنشتغل بيه هيكون ال initial rate لان ده اعلى value للريت ممكن تبقى موجودة وقت ال reaction. فاحسن لنا طبعا ان احنا نشتغل بيها و ناخدها into consideration واحنا بنقارن ال reactions ببعض. طيب تعالوا الاول نشوف reaction 1 و reaction 2 ونقارنهم ببعض. Experiment 1 has a concentration of ammonium of 0.01 molars and nitrite has a concentration of 0.2. In experiment 2, we doubled the concentration of ammonium. It reached 0.02 molar while the concentration of nitrite is kept constant. So in this case, reactant 1 is doubled while reactant 2 is kept constant. Let's check what happened to the rate when we doubled the concentration of reactant 1. The rate also has doubled. Doubling the concentration of the first reactant and keeping the second constant, resulting in doubling the rate of the chemical reaction. بما اننا زودنا الconcentration بتاع واحد من الreactants عملنا له doubling, ضربناه في اتنين, لقينا برضو ان الrate هو كمان حصل له doubling. تمام؟ طيب تعالوا نشوف example تاني. Let's check for another example. Let's check experiments 5 and 6. In experiments 5 and 6, the concentration of ammonium has been kept constant, while the concentration of nitrite has been doubled. It has been doubled, okay? So in this case, the second reactant is doubled while the first reactant has been kept constant. What happened to the rate in this case? The rate has also doubled. The rate has also been doubled. So we can see that the rate has been doubled by the effect of any of the reactants. It has been doubled by the effect of any of the two reactants. Let's talk about K. What about the rate constant K? Rate constant is different value for different reactions, which means that each reaction has its own K value. Each reaction has its own K value. K value is constant, is kept in the textbooks. It's not something to be memorized or calculated. It's a measure for the reaction rate. It's independent on the reactant concentrations. So the concentrations change, rate change, while rate constant is kept constant. So the concentrations and the rate of the chemical reactions change, while the rate constant remains fixed. It only varies with temperature. Changes in temperature affects the K value.